Hello, everyone. Welcome to part 12 of my Cityville construction project here. I'm recording this one when people are trying to sleep, so I need to keep the volume down a bit. Hopefully everyone can still hear me okay. Last time I finished off pretty much everything in the northeast section of the city here. This time I'm going to start development expansion around this offshoot community here. I'll probably start with some stuff right along the highway around here where this area would logically spill over. So, what do I have here? Okay, so what I'm going to do here, just like on this side, I'm going to run a green space along the highway here, and that, well, it happens to work well with my sense of symmetry, but it also serves as a noise barrier as well. It saves having concrete walls. Now, first up, I'm going to do something similar as over here. Now, what have I got? Okay, so I've got this big roundabout here. I think what'll happen is I'll bring a road, an avenue off directly over here and have some development here. So first, the avenue, there we go. This will be a backbone road on this side here. So along here, I'm going to put commercial development, I believe. Let's see what the demands are looking like. Hard to say what would be a good choice there. Anyway, I'll start with some commercial here. Put some larger ones here. And what am I going to do here? I'll make this one smaller. And I'll bring a road across like this. And like so. Okay. So there's the first little bit over there, and of course it needs water, like everywhere. You know, as you saw early in the series, a lot of this stuff will develop without water, but the water gives you the higher wealth developments, and also some of the larger developments, and you really do need those if you want your city to really develop. I think I'm going to end up putting a flyover in over here somewhere, ultimately. Anyway, we have a commercial area here. I'm going to put a residential area here. Like so. you can see there's a fair bit of slope here. And you can see some of the weirdness that zoning tends to do on slopes here. You see it kind of dips in the middle. It doesn't make any sense that it does that, but it does. Okay, so the forest is going to come out to here. The green space. So, at least along here it will. Now, let's see what the budget looks like. Okay, so what I'm going to do is put a school over here. Now, I think this probably gets rid of the need for these schools down here. Yes, it would seem to. Okay, so while that's ticking along, I'm going to work on the forest over here. Like on the other side, I'm going to come up within two tiles of the edge of the highway. And I'm going to put grass beside the bridge, like on the other side. Now, within the interchange here, I'm going to plant some grass right beside the road. Doing this has a couple of advantages. The biggest of of the advantages is it brings everything close enough that power lines aren't needed to link the two areas. So by doing this with the grass in the median as well, I pretty much totally eliminate the need for this power line here. While I'm at it, I'll add the trees over here as well. Okay. So, by having this green space, this grass area beside the highway, instead of the trees right up to it, you avoid the trees deciding to grow in the road, and also you don't block the visibility for the traffic that's merging from the crossroad here. Okay, so we can see this has filled in quite a bit. Go for some commercial over on this side as well. I'm going to end up getting a little more creative over here because I have this existing road which I've decided I'm not going to remove. Again with the utilities. And I believe I'll have to bring one up this way as well. Okay. Now how much space do I have here? I have 7. Okay, so I made a cul-de-sac here because this corner is going around to the big roundabout here, but I can have a connection here nicely. Okay, make this commercial as well. And remember, this is going to be forest up here a ways anyway, but I'm going to put some commercial here. I should fill in the rest of the forest over here. Okay, so that pretty much covers that. I'll extend the grass area here. Okay, it looks like I'll have to skip that. Dope. Is this as simple as redragging? No. Of course it's not. So what I need to do is put my ramp back because I just destroyed it. Okay. That's easy enough to do. This was a... This was a flex ramp, I believe. I believe it was that one. Okay. Clearly. Right. Okay. What's up with that? Clearly that's not a flex ramp that I had there. A regular ramp, didn't I? That has to be the one I used. And it was probably because of that glitchiness there. Okay. There we go. Now, to finish with my grass here. But remember not to put one here. Okay. Okay. So over here, on this side, I'm going to drop down to a medium density on the residential. And I'm also going to put a medium density residential in here, I believe. So I need to figure out how I'm going to lay this out. So I have 11. Well, I'll put a road here. 2, 3, 4, 5. And a road like so. Yeah, I think I'll do that. Now, I need my development here. Okay, so that's some more residential there. Now, this area here needs to connect up. No, that doesn't work. Okay. Okay, so you can see the population is up around 170,000 Sims now. I'll speed the simulation up for a bit here, and then we'll see what the development does. Again, you can observe that there's no budget problem. So, as you can see, being just a little bit careful along the way, you can pretty much avoid any budgetary trouble in a city, even a large one. Interesting fact to point out is with regard to trash. If we go back over here, you take a look, and you may notice on some forums and so on, people discussing how it's ruinously expensive to deal with trash in a city, especially a large city. Well, as you can see, this is the entire capacity this city has for dealing with trash currently. And if we take a look in the budget, and that would be no, it would be in utilities. Yeah, here we go. Sanitation department. You can see that the sanitation department, including the landfill, is setting us back less than 4,000 simoleons. So what it really comes down to is, regardless what you may have read somewhere, you do not need to do anything to deal with your trash. Pollution, on the other hand, can be problematic. Ooh, we got a hospital. Number of patients. This one is running. Well, okay, yeah, that one's definitely underfunded. There we go. That sorts out much of our issue there. I'll drop the simulation back now that it's had time to run a bit. And as you can see, this has filled in a bit. So, do we have anything in here? A country club. A university, monthly cost. You know, university seems like a good investment at this point in time. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to do something totally bizarre. I'm just going to randomly plop it in. Now, I'm going to what do you know? I'm going to connect it up to the transportation. There we go. I'm also going to connect it to the water system. There we go. And for the moment, I'm going to need to connect it to the power system. There we go. Now, over here, I'm going to put in some city services. There we go. It looks like they're having a convocation in there. Okay. And there we have a university. Now, I believe, okay, somewhere some teachers are. Hmm. No, that doesn't tell me anything useful. Well, anyway. Apparently, an advanced research center wants to come along. Now, this doesn't cost anything on an ongoing basis, so there's no point not building it. It does generate some interesting news reports on occasion, though. Demands are starting to climb again. I need some more residential going on. Which is easy enough remedied. Good. Now on this side, some more water to install here. Good. Okay. We have the university is underfunded, apparently. Let's just max it out. Budget's there. There we go. Good. That's a lot of digits of pi. Anyway. Give the game a save here, make sure it doesn't crash out and take everything with it. Up over 180,000 sims now. Now I made this area here high density for the residential, partly for the proximity of the university, and partly proximity to the other development over here. This is medium density though, and that's because of the proximity to the stuff over here. Okay, let's speed things up a bit so things can fill in faster. Okay, so it's filling in nicely here. You can see the population of Cityville is over 190,000 Sims. Here we go. The demand is staying relatively high on the residential. These need to increase a bit still. Okay, so I'm going to extend this avenue out to this one. Link it up like so. Now, what's the distance here? 12. Yeah, that doesn't work so nicely. Okay, so I'll split it. There we go. Okay. I'll put some put some high density stuff in here. Okay. And fill in the utilities. Note here, I put a 5x4, I believe, lot in here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. So there is a 5x. Well, that's interesting. Let's look at the zone view there. That's in here. Zones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's a 5x4 space. And it's a single. It's a gallery. I'm going to also fill that with commercial there. And make that residential. Okay. Okay, good. As you can see, the budget is still healthy. I'm going to slow the game back down now. And before I call it a part, I'm going to fill this in. So, first of all, I'll put the grass. And just like on the other side, no grass there. So I'll go the whole length here. Now, with these buildings here, I'm going to drop the median here for the grass to one tile. Median in the highway as well. These actually provide some demand cap relief, so it's useful building them as well. At least when I looked into it, they did. Okay, now for the trees. Okay, so I need to fill in here and be careful not to demolish my building there. Okay, that's better. Still have to be careful not to demolish the buildings. Now the nice thing is building these here increases the property value and desirability, which helps these bigger buildings here grow. Okay. That gives the this area here a reasonably nice looking finish. Now there's limited things we can do to sort this sort of thing out. So, you know, we do our best and leave it at that. Even so, there's a little bit more I can do over here. Bring the grass all the way up to the flyover thing here. And in the median as well. And also in the intervening space between the park road here and the highway. And again, we can't build here because it overlaps the highway. Okay. Hey, you know what? I'm close enough to the edge. I'm just gonna run this all the way down while I'm thinking about it so I don't forget to do it. And if you recall, there's supposed to be a neighbor piece connector in here. So I'll need to fix that as well. So the neighbor connection really isn't working properly. And on this side as well. Okay, time to fix that neighbor connection there. Neighbor connector. See, so we have to have this transparent piece here, which means we can't put grass there. And we need a 8S neighbor connector. Okay. Now, just to show you, I can't place it here because now that neighbor connection is there. Okay, yep. Okay, I'll save it now. Now, what I'm going to do is let this run for a little bit here and see if that neighbor connection actually does anything. It may be too far from any of the, by road anyway, from any of the industry and so on. And there is nothing in the neighboring city. Put the simulation back to a normal speed now. Okay, so now I'm gonna call it a part here. Next time, I believe some development along in here, either that or around the university. Anyway. Well, I'll call it a part here. Thank you for watching. See you next time.